Hello everyone, today we are going to see how the functions can be passed as arguments. In general, argument to a function can be of any type like int, char, float, list, tuple, dictionary, and even it could be another function. To illustrate it, we will see three simple function definitions and how you invoke all these three functions. First, in the function A, does not take any arguments and it also does not return any value. Function B takes an argument and it returns the same without making any change in the function definition. The third function C, it takes an argument and it returns the same. From the return statement, we can understand that this argument passed could be of a function. It will be a function. Right. We will see how to invoke all these three functions. In the first statement, you are invoking function A, which doesn't take any parameter. In this next statement, you are invoking function B that takes an argument. We are passing it as 2. And this insists as one more point that you can use your function call as a part of your expression. In the third statement, you are invoking function C, and this function C takes one parameter, and that parameter is another function which is nothing but function A. Now we will see what happens when you invoke all these functions. Okay. Now, when I invoke, when you run this program, first, we will see how the memory will be allocated and how the function call works. When you run this program, memory will be allocated for function A, function B, and function C. This portion indicates that the memory needed for that particular code. Okay. When you invoke the function A, the function A scope come to existence. Function A does not need any special memory for variable because it doesn't have any variable as an argument or even inside its function. So when you invoke this particular function A, it will just print inside function A. As you don't have any return statements, it will return none to the calling function, right? It will return none to the calling function. So you will get none printed. In the next statement, when you invoke 5 plus function of B, the call will move to function B. So a memory will be allotted for the function B. In the function B, you need to allocate variable for memory for the variable Y. So a copy of memory for Y is created. The value 2 is copied from the functional call over there. Then it will print the statement inside function B. Then it will return the same. So the value 2 will be returned to the calling function. That means here you will have 5 plus 2. So the value 5 plus 2, 7 will get printed as output. So now we will see what happens when you invoke the third function. When I invoke the third function, first the control will move for the function C. And from the function C, I'm going to my argument as function A. So the control will move for function A. And in the function A, I will print inside function A. Then the return will be transferred to function C. Here again, it will print inside function C and the control will be get back to the main function. That is what represented here. See, first I will make a call to the function C. From here, it will make a call to function A. From here, it will return that, and then the control is passed to function C. Okay. To explain it in more, we will see another example. Before we get into the example, we will see some simple code snippets. Here, I have defined two functions. The first function helps us to find the sum of n natural numbers. And the second function helps us to find the sum of cubes, n cubic numbers. Okay. We will see how the code works. See here, This is one of the beauty of Python, where you can assign multiple variable values at a time. Here the total will be allotted as assigned as 0 value, and k will be assigned as 1, right? Okay, so I told this function will perform sum of n natural numbers. The n value I am going to pass it as 3. So my expectation is the function has to return me one value of 1 plus 2 plus 3. So how the code works means, initially the value total will be allotted as 0 and k is 1 until the k value is less than or equal to n. That means until the k value becomes 4, this statement will be executed. At the first iteration, the k value will become k plus 1, that is it will become 1, and the total value will become total plus k, that is already total is 0, so it will become 1. On the second iteration, the k value will be 2, and the total value will be the previous value of total plus the current k value, it is 3. In the next iteration, k value will be 3 and the total value will be 6. On the next iteration, k value will become 4. The condition will be violated and you will come outside the loop. Okay. In the same way, this code snippet works, but the only change is, instead of this k, I have given as k into k into k. That is, I want to find the sum of cubic numbers. The rest remains the same. That is what represented here. So if I want to again find sum of square numbers, I have to define another function where this term has to be replaced by k into k, k square. So from this understanding, we can conclude a point that we can have a generalized function where you have to pass the number of terms, right? Number of, that is the n value, and the term for which you have to calculate the sum. Then you can have a generalized function. With this understanding, we will move for the next step. Based on our previous slides, we have defined this generalized function. This is the name of the function to be given, and this is the number of terms you have to go. This is the particular term. So my function should also have this term as input, and this term could be another function. If I want sum of natural number, I can call the sum of naturals. If I want sum of cubes, I can call sum of cubes. If I want sum of squares, then I can call sum of squares. With this, we have defined three functions. The first function is the just replica of this, which will perform the summation of n terms. And this term will get input from the function. See here, I am going to use cube function, right? First, we will see how it works, and then we will see the visualization. So, when this particular statement is executed, sum of cubes 3, sum cubes will be invoked, which in turn will invoke the function summation. This summation will take n input as 3, the term as cube, right? Now, this particular iteration will get executed for 3 times with the term function as cube. That is what represented here. It will work for until k value becomes 4, and each time what will be the term value is given here and the corresponding total is listed. So the final value what you will get here is your result, that is your 36. Now we will see how this could be pictorially explained. Now we will execute this code step by step. So on seeing the function definition, in global frame, a memory is allotted for that. On seeing cube, the memory is allotted for that. Then for a sum cube function, then on invoking the statement, result is equal to sum of cube, there will be a function call to sum of cubes. And in sum of cubes, you have in turn, you have called the summation function, and See, when you invoke the function called sum of cubes, you have passed an argument 3. So, in the 3 has been this n is equal to 3. You have a value of n is equal to 3. Okay. Now, the function has been transferred to summation and it has two parameters. The first is n value. First, the 3 has been copied over its own location. N is equal to 3 and this term is pointing to the cube function. Term is pointing to the cube function. Now the call, now the value total will be allotted as 0 and k will be allotted as 1. Then it will check for the condition. Then you will have a here there will be a call to the term of k, right? And on execution of you have got the value k value as 1 and it will return 1 into 1 into 1 as 3. See, 1 into 1 into 1 as 1, so the return value is 1. On getting the return value as 1, now the total value will become 0 plus 1 as 1. And again this condition is true. So you will, on executing the next statement, again there will be a call to the term function with x is equal to 2. On execution, it will return 2 into 2 into 2, 8. It will return 8 value. The 8 value will be returned over here. That is already in total you had the value as 1. So 1 plus 8 you have now value as 9 and k is 2 plus 1 3. Again the condition will be true because 3 is less than or equal to true. Next, the cube is invoked now with the value of 3. So it will return 3 into 3 into 3, 27. When this 27 is returned back here, already the total value is 9. So the total will be updated to 36. See, when 27 is returned, it is updated to 36 and the k value is 4. So now the condition will be false and it will return total to the called function. So it will return, see, it will return 36 over, it will return 36 to the sum of cube function, which in turn will return it to the value result. See, this is returned to the result and now it will print the value 36. See, you can make use of this pythontutor.com to visualize your code execution. Thank you.